Hello guys and welcome back. So for today we are going to apply some silicone render on this wall here and show you how exactly I'm going to apply it. So for a start, we have our silicone render here, which is from Ceresit. It's 1.5 mil stone inside of it. The wall was already prepared. You have the mesh reinforced with adhesive. It's a special adhesive for external wall insulation. It has some fibers in it and different properties of a normal render. It was already primered and now we just need to apply this top coat on. So without any further ado, let's just start and apply the render on. First of all, you need a trowel. I'm going to use my big trowel. I have the small one here. And you can use a hook or something like that. I don't usually do that. I'm just going to apply some silicone here, some render, and just put it on. Now, if you are going to go too far and you are not going to have enough render on your trowel, it's just going to fall down. So I'm always putting a little bit more, and after that I'm going to take it out. And doing that, I'm going to do even a level surface. This is exactly what I mean. If I'm going to try to pull it out too much, it's just going to fall. See, it's falling. So that's why you need to use a lot of it. So right now I think I will have enough to finish the entire wall. So I think I have enough on the wall extra so I can finish the entire wall. So I'm just going to pull it out. I'm just going to do the corners by pushing and raising it up a little bit. And like that, I'm going to have nice clean corners and the render is going to go everywhere. And same, I'm going to do under the windowsill. And at the bottom, I'm just going to do that. And then I'm pulling it up. So I have taken a little bit on my trowel and I'm going to do the top side now. Alright, so right now I'm just going to take the excess off from the wall. Okay. Okay, so right now I have a nice even surface and I just need to wait for around 10 minutes or so for it to go off just a little bit, and after that I am just going to smooth it up a little bit with this plastic float. It's a thin plastic float. It's just made for this type of system, so silicone renders. And yeah, at this moment I'm just going to wait, see when exactly it's going to go off and start smoothing it up. So let's just take a small break right now and we are going to come back in about 10 minutes. Alright, so I think that is enough. Now we just have to smooth it up. So make sure that your float is nice and clean, and then you just need to do circular moves, doesn't matter which way, and you just have to go everywhere. Now I'm just going to clean it from the excess. And do some more. You are going to get some black spots like that. Just put some more render on. And then smooth it up. And clean. Okay, so our wall is done now. Everything is nice and smooth. Well, smooth for this type of render, because we have a 1.5 mil stone in net, which is quartz. A quartz stone is inside this type of render. And yeah, pretty much that's it. Now we just have to clean, take some take our protection out, clean the window sills even at the back, because you might get some render on. If you want, you can use some masking tape. You just put the masking tape and then you you take it off and job is done. I don't like to do that, because once that you take the masking tape off, if you didn't put it properly in a straight line or too close to the wall, then you are going to take out all the render and you are going to have a line, and then you are going to have to pass over, and if it's too late, it's not good to pass over on top of this type of render, because it's going to mess it up and you cannot repair it anymore. You should do it again. You will have to do it again. So I prefer, when I can, not to use the masking tape. Usually I'm using ducting tape, because that is going to stick more to the surface and it's going to give me less problems. But I'm going to take it off as soon as I finish, because if I'm going to leave it for the second day, it might be that it's going to leave a lot of glue on the actual fittings, windows, windowsills, and so on. So I'm preferring to take it off as soon as I finish. Like on that. That is just a glimpse of what I have done here. You can see all that side over there on my other video. But for now, this was how am I finishing off this type of render. So anyway, if you have any questions, just leave me a comment down below and I will try to answer as soon as I can. At this point, our video came to an end. Of course, don't forget to like and subscribe, and see you on the next one.